Good morning, Holmdel. Welcome to Bell Works. Today is Monday, December 30th, and in 2 days from now, I will officially leave the post that I've served for the last 9 years. 3 years as your mayor, 4 years as your deputy mayor, and 2 years as a committeeman. It's been an incredible learning experience, one that I'm incredibly grateful that I was given the opportunity to do. But I would like to take a few seconds and just recap some of the magical things that we've been able to do in the last 9 years to make Holmdel a better place. I think the legacy starts and probably ends with Bell Works, a one-time vacant building. We've been able to revitalize this and make it New Jersey's greatest success in the last 45 years. This redevelopment program will generate over $6 million for the town of Holmdel for generations to come. Your municipal taxes should not go up for a very long time. And I'm proud of the work that we did here, how we drove ISIMS here, and all of the other pieces that we were able to put together. But it's more than just the revenue here at Bell Works. It's become a community hub where people come together and they're able to use some of the things like the golf simulator, gyms, etc. So it's a meeting place for Holmdel. Clearly, it's been on the top of the list of priorities, and I'm happy to say that we got it done. When you look at finances within a town, it's very hard to get everything that you want done because taxes play a huge role in the state of New Jersey. We're getting chased out of our state, and I'm proud to say that we were able to keep municipal taxes incredibly flat, completely flat in the last 2 years. You have to do this by reducing expenses or increasing revenue. We increased revenue, and I'd like to say we've taken a number of steps to keep our expenses flat. Still, you have to spend some money. Where do you want to spend money? You want to spend it with safety. This year alone, I didn't lead the charge to close the firehouse, but I certainly led the charge to get a new fire truck this year and to get a number of new volunteers, so maintaining safety. When you talk about the finances for the future of Holmdel, we're now AAA rated, one of two towns in Monmouth County, one of 19 in the state. So as the state can be fiscally irresponsible, but at the end of the day, Holmdel was not. I entered here, we had a deficit. I leave here with a surplus. The true passion, what really made me happy, was making a difference within our community. We did all kinds of things to bring the community together. Community cleanup was one of my favorites. Seeing over 100 people just grab garbage all over town. It's free and it was fun. We also sponsored corporations. Goldman Sachs came over with a whole group and did work at Bayonet Farms, and we did a number of things to have where corporations could help the community of Holmdel. We did things like daddy-daughter sleep out. We wanted to make sure that we always looked out for everyone. When I think of Strive and some of the organizations and some of our special needs kids in the school, we partnered, and now I'm proud to say that almost a dozen of them are working here at Bell Works, all initiatives that I started within the town of Holmdel. For the first time in over 20 years, Holmdel is going to invest in recreation. I partner with Committeeman Tom Critelli, and I'm proud to say that we finally pushed through some bonding that will allow us to improve our parks. We have a long way to go. For Holmdel, we're so far behind the other towns when it comes to facilities that our children can utilize. And we want to make sure that they're active with all the distractions that go on. It's the best defense against drugs and the opioid crisis. I'm proud of some of the community things that we did, like hangout over at Vonage that we did just to bring the kids together, to give alternatives for the children. And I'm so proud that we were able to bring the theater into the community. I led a VIP charge to bring some others to get involved and to keep some of the legacy that Wendell Smith brought when he opened up the Duncan Smith Theater. It needed a little love. We added that to the recreation, and I'm proud of the new risers that will go into that theater. So for generations to come, Holmdel has supported the arts within our own town. We're supporting the arts, we're supporting the sports. We also tried real hard for the first time in decades to preserve some open land. We are able to do the Callan Farm, and next year we will close on an initiative that I started with over 70 acres being preserved in southern Holmdel. Preserving land, taking care of our children, fighting for lower taxes, making sure that we're a solid community. This has been an incredible run. I'm blessed to have done it. You know, when I look back, I think of a few things. Did I always do the right thing? One of the first meetings I ever had, they wanted to raise taxes on the sewers. I end up agreeing with my Democratic colleague at the time, and I fought hard against it. So I chose to go against my own party. I did the right thing. did I do the best I can? Every single week, every one day a week, I went over and I met with the police chief, our director of recreation, our director of infrastructure, and I tried to keep an incredible pulse on the town so I knew all the little things that were happening. And did I impact others? Yeah, I think that I looked after the children of Holmdel, the future of Holmdel. I think I tried to answer anyone that ever emailed me on a regular basis. So I'd like to think that I made a real positive impact on the town of Holmdel. I always did the right thing. I did the best I could, and we helped some people along the way. And I think that's how I'd like to be remembered. God bless. Happy New Year. Goodbye, Holmdel.